Welcome to this video, in which I'm going to describe the birth of my concept of a bandeau pattern. Initially, I developed this design when I was costuming and directing a production of 42nd Street, and I wanted to do a costume that was inspired by Erte that required a special kind of a top. And so the idea of doing a bandeau top came to me. Now, but instead, usually where I have always perceived the bandeau to be is just a very flat piece of fabric drawing across, and I wanted to have something that reflected the shape of the breast nicely. And so I came up with a different approach to creating the pattern. The pattern, as you can see, is not a straight pattern. What it does is it has a dart from the center front seam to the apex of the bust, and the idea is to shape the lower portion of the pattern based on the lower part of the body and the upper portion of the body on the upper part of the body, and so it gives you much more shaping than if it was just one straight piece of fabric going across. And this is the top that actually I used in that particular production. And it's the very first time I've tried to apply the bandeau pattern to an undergarment. I've always used it for outer garments with different forms of support. But I was really curious to see what would happen if we used it as a bra, the concept of a bra. So what I've done here is I've used some fabric that's very similar to power net that's used in bras. It's got a foam cup, it's got the standard bra elastic at the top and the bottom, and we've put the typical bra back closing here. In particular styling, what we're looking at is to hold the garment in place by a combination of the elastic above the breast and below the breast. And by using an elastic fabric, we get full support around the rib cage. It's strapless. So, Alex, you wore this bra for the first time today. Give us your feeling about it.
Well, it's a really nice feeling to not have anything sort of weighing the shoulders down. I like that aspect of sort of feeling free up here. It's a problem if it's not tight enough. I found myself before you adjusted it with it kind of sliding down around my waist, which is not helpful. So that's...
Yeah. One of the things that there is always an alternative is we can add straps. You can add straps like any other one, any other bra you would make. So you can have a strap across the top and to the back, crossing over. And actually what I will probably be doing is putting a loop in here with a G-hook, which means it could be a convertible bra. It could be either a strapless or a strapped bra. I actually asked Alex if she would field test this without the straps to give me some additional feedback on the construction of the bra. One of the very important things to me about this bra is that it starts with a straight pattern. Now, what this is saying to me is that if a woman has had a radical mastectomy and has lost the shaping of one side, she could create this pattern for the side that remained and use the other side to put a pocket for any kind of a prosthetic device in there. So I think this is an ideal kind of a garment. It doesn't require underwires to stay in place. It can be adjusted for a mastectomy. You can add straps or not, depending on what you want and how to make a conventional bra. And this is not a conventional bra. You're not going to get the same kind of a shaping and styling, or you're not going to have the push-up look. There's a lot that you won't get from this. But if it's a alternative style that you find comfortable, then it's a very easy bra to make. It is the easiest bra I have ever made. One pattern is cut twice. There's one dart seam. There's one center front seam. On the inside, I have secured the foam, a tricot foam, so that the bra cup retains its shape. Now, what I find that for smaller women, it's nice because it retains the shape, and for larger women, the foam will add additional support. And then with the bra back hook and closing and the bra back band and stuff, these bras can go together very, very quickly with minimal equipment, and you really don't need to go into all the detailed sewing that's involved in a conventional bra.